I thought that this was an important thing to say at this time, Mr. Trump. Who fixates on TV ratings? He publicly pondered his middle-of-the-night ratings while greeting freed American prisoners from North Korea at an airbase this month was impressed by the strong showing of the Roseanne reboot's premiere. In March, he called Ms. Barr to congratulate her, and later, at a rally in Ohio, he closely aligned his populist message with the series' success, telling the crowd that the sitcom's high ratings had been about us. After her triumphant return to network TV, Ms. Barr swiftly lost her show, but inflammatory tweets sent from her account had never been out of the ordinary. Ms. Barr's message targeting Ms. Jarrett was the latest in a string of retweets and original posts, some since deleted, some still visible, that indulge in conspiracy theories, links to pro-Israel articles and attacks against the news media. In the aftermath of her show's cancellation, she apologized, blaming the Twitter messages in part on the sleep aid and the Memorial Day holiday. In another post that has since been removed, Ms. Barr asked her supporters to not defend her comments, saying that they were made at 2 in the morning and I was ambient tweeting it was Memorial Day too, she said. I went too far, do not want it defended, it was egregious, indefensible. Sanofi, the maker of Ambien, immediately pushed back. People of all races, religions and nationalities work at Sanofi every day to improve the lives of people around the world, the company said on Twitter. While all pharmaceutical treatments have side effects, racism is not a known side effect of any Sanofi medication. Thank you for watching. For the follow-up, subscribe to the channel yourself here.